Also, they have this whole scene in front of the transporter chief that is not O'Brien.
Right.
And that
even
reason,
though the Netflix thing says it's O'Brien calling from the bridge.
Commander Riker to transporter room 3.
Now, here's the craziest thing in the whole episode.
This is more than a surprise. It's total shock.
You mean you didn't bake me a cake?
You're actually here.
That makes two of us. How about a drink?
How about a kiss?
A kiss? Right off the bat? How long has it been?
They know each other.
No kidding. Well, I know her too, but we don't do that.
What does that mean?
It's good,
what
is good Chief O'Brien.
What is that shot?
I don't kiss her when I see her.
You look wonderful.
He's saying they must more than know each other, Riker.
Right. Huh? That's your dad.
Stroke your beard, Rike. That scene where he's saying goodbye to Troy, it felt like he or she was a holodeck character and the other one was like rehearsing for how the goodbye would go.
The one scene where Wesley runs after Worf and is pointlessly provoking him and Worf is acting completely out of control.
Yeah.
They feel like anime characters in this scene.
Be gone!
This show's Hoopla included a visit by Entertainment Tonight cameras, who were following E.T. host and unabashed Trek fan John Tesh through the 2 hours of makeup necessary to turn him into one of Worf's Ascension Chamber tormentors. Tesh, all 6 feet six of him, is the Klingon closest to the viewer on the left. Thanks to the Klingon shortage caused by the simultaneous shooting of Star Trek V, wardrobe was running low, and two of the Klingons got to wear old Planet of the Apes boots. So after being poked a lot, Worf gets very happy.
Thank you for watching me.